Then the brief I tell you right now. Okay. See, this is the things what we have read on that introduction part, what we have read. We have read here chord, radius, diameter, secant, tangent. This one you know, Trishi? This many things you know?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the first part we have read. Now next is your tangent and circle is properties we have done. If you have drawn any tangent to, what is tangent, you know? The tangent will lie only one point on the, means one point you can draw only one tangent, okay? That we have read in the last class. So you can see in this figure, your tangent is AC and BC. BC and AC are the tangents, okay? So this both from a single point, what you draw from the outside, that will be nothing but this is your tangent and this is also tangent. This both are equal. Means AC is equals to what? BC. Again, this is your OA and OB are diameters. So this diameters are, this is radius. So radius are also equal. And one property is there, angle between radius and tangent is 90 degree. Again, here also you can see angle between radius and tangent is what? 90 degree. Okay. Now by congruency, by congruent, you can just write this, both triangles are congruent. By RHS criterion, this both triangles are what? Congruent. You know this much?
Yes, sir.
By angle is 90 degree. Again, hypotenuse are common over here, hypotenuse. And your side is equal. See, radius one is equal. So this angle and this angle is also equal. And if you compare, this angle is equal to this angle. These are the basic concept. Okay. So these two angles are equal. Again, these two angles are equal. You can just write here.
Properties. Yes, sir.
So these are the properties what we have read in the last class. Similarly, we have to find now here proving some asking. These are the basic concept only. And next one is here you have to prove that the tangents drawn at the end of diameter of a circle. It means just try once. You got Radharsh? Answer you got?
I don't know what it is. I was there in the last class.
You are not there in the last class. See, can you see this question here? See, this is the circle. Your diameter is given over here. A to B is a diameter. Okay. So you know that angle between radius and tangent is what? 90 degree. The angle 1 and angle 2 are what? 90 degree. Correct? So here, what you have to prove here? The diameter, this diameter is parallel to this. Correct? Adarsh? So see here, AB is a diameter. P and Q are the tangents. P and Q are two tangents. So OA is perpendicular to P. Angle 1 is equals to angle 2, that is 90 degree. That you know already. So P is parallel to Q because angle 1 and 2 are what? Alternate angles. So this much has only got proved over. That's it. Small concept was there. That's it. Is it clear? Shreyas, you have done the same thing.
Yes, sir, I'm doing it.
Same way we have done. You are trying same way or different way you have done?
In some different way I'm trying.
Okay. Because if you can use here both radius, angle between radius and tangent is 90 degree. So obviously angle 1 and angle 2 is equal to 90 degree. And this is possible only when if P is parallel to Q, right? So which is the other method, Shreyas, you are doing here? Shreyas, can you hear me?
Yes.
Now we'll do question number 5. Okay, question number 5 we do now. Question number fifth.
Sir.
Huh. Hello.
This question by a different method.
Okay, which method? Which method?
Yes.
Huh?
Yeah, okay, so I did that just a
minute. I'm not able to hear properly. I don't know why. Samarth? We're having network problem. Praharshan, Chanchal, Drishi, all of you on the camera. Praharshan, Chanchal, Drishi. Chanchal, when it comes to the meeting only, we can't able to get. She's not speaking anything. Chanchal, your network is proper, right?
So you are able to hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you now. Now, which method you have done? You are telling something you have done by some other method, right?
Yeah, so I took 2 points on both sides with same length and then drew 2 lines from to the opposite points through the center. So okay. It constructed 4 triangles.
Okay.
4 right triangles. So I proved that one is any opposite to are similar. And then... So by proving it similar, the angles are equal. Hence, those are alternate angles. Hence, okay. This is a transversal and P is parallel to Q.
Okay. Fine. Now, second question is like this. Second question means question number fifth. Prove that perpendicular at a point of contact to the tangent to a circle passes through the center. This is the next question, question number fifth. Prove that the perpendicular at a point of contact to the tangent to a circle passes through the center. So what they're asking, you are understanding, got to understand what actually they are asking in the question. Prove that perpendicular at a point of contact. What is point of contact? You know that, Drishi? See, this is the point of contact where this tangent meet at the circle. This is point of contact. So prove that the perpendicular at the point of contact to the tangent. It means that which perpendicular they are saying here? Means from the center, if you draw here, say this is a circle. This is a point of contact. From the center, if you draw the perpendicular here, point of contact to tangent to a circle passing through the. So here, what is happening? Passing through the center. This will pass through center. You have to prove that. This is passing through the center of the circle. This is a converse like this thing. If you draw any perpendicular to the point of contact to the tangent, if you're drawing any perpendicular line to the tangent from the circle, so this point will be what? This point is nothing but center only. You have to prove this is the center. So how to prove this is the center? Samarth, do you know how to prove? In the next class, children, new tab
yes,
is coming.
I know about it.
Some this tab problem is just something happened in my tab. So it's coming on 31st. After 31st, we'll just write and do. In the meantime, just copy and paste I'm doing here right now. From 31st, okay. New tab is coming. So I'll write that time only, huh? Because here it's not writing properly. So
you're buying a whole new tab.
What, Samarth?
So you're buying a whole new tab.
Yes. New tab. Tab is good, no? How you write? Yeah. Writing, you can't write by only mouse or something, right?
No, mouse we cannot write, but pen tab something comes like that.
Yeah.
You can connect it to the computer and then you can write.
So that pen only something inside something happened, I think. That's why it's right. Yeah. If I write something, it's spreading automatically. So okay. The fifth one is like this. So here, see, in the given figure, AXB is the tangent. This you understood is tangent is a center with to a circle with center O. Here OX is perpendicular to the tangent AXB at the point of contact S. The point of contact is X over here. Point of contact is X. Now just if you see OXB, this is 90 degree. BXY, this is also 90 degree, is equal to 180 degree. So OXY is collinear. OXY is what? Collinear. So OX passes through the center of the circle. This is a simple things it's given here. Anyway, you know that, right? So what is given here? OX, you know, this is already the radius of the circle and tangent. Makes 90 degree, that you know, right? And the same radius is extended till Y. So this angle, first angle and second angle is what? 180 degree. Okay. So OXY is nothing but what? Collinear. That's why OX passes through the center. Same thing again and again we are saying this. Is it clear? What is asking here? First you try to understand what is the question only is. The question is, if you're drawing any perpendicular to the point of contact on the tangent, this contact, this what you are having, this perpendicular is nothing but this will pass through the center of the circle. So what we have done, we know that the angle between radius of the circle and tangent is 90 degree, and we have extended the same line to the Y. So this 90 and 90 become 180. The same line is passing to the center, obviously. So that's got proved. That's it. Is it clear, Drishi? No.
Sir, right. Why can't we say that, you know, since the radius will be perpendicular to the point of contact, so the perpendicular from the point of contact is the radius, and that's how it's
possible. Yeah, that say. Only. Yeah. So radius is nothing but from the center only. That also we can say, right? Radius is also originating from center. Correct, no? So obviously it passed through the center of the circle. So that only want to see from like this way. Means you can say that also, yes. Radius originate only from where? Radius originates from where? From center. But how to prove? That is the main thing. So for that, only for formality, we have to write these two lines over here. This one and this one. This question they won't ask, but you have to prove. We know only, just to write here, we know only radius originating from always with the center. The radius is nothing but from the center of the circle to the circumference, right? Obviously, this center is coming, this radius is coming out of center, right? But proving part we have done in two different ways, two different lines. So now question number six, you see, question number six is... Question number six is very, very easy. All of you can do easier. This is the finding thing. You have to find this. Read the question and try to find this. Question number six. See, the length of the tangent. Try to draw the diagram first. If finding thing will be easier always, right? The length of the tangent of from point A at a distance 5 centimeters from the center of the circle is 4 centimeters. Find the radius of the circle. The length of tangent from a point A, distance 5 centimeters from the center of the circle is 4 centimeters. Find the radius of the circle. What is the radius of the circle?
Sir, is it 3?
But this everyone knows, right? Last time also we have done this type of question, right?
Yes, sir, it's simple. It's a triplet.
So radius is 3. So this is the diagram and all that you know already. 6th, 7th question we have done already. Question number 8th also we have done. Question number 9th we have not done, right? 12th, very important sum we have done, 12th question. Now question number 9th and all we have to do. Question number 8th we have done. After question number 8th, we have to do question number 9th. Question number 9th is... See this question number 9. In the figure, XY and X dash Y dash are two parallel tangents to a circle X with center O and another tangent AB with center of and AB, another tangent AB with point of contact C. Intersecting XY at A and X dash Y dash at B, prove that AOB is equals to 90 degree. Okay, prove that AOB is equals to what?
90 degrees. It can be done, sir. Simple.
AOB means this angle you have to find. This is 90 degree, right? How to find? How it can be done? Tell someone.
Just know that OCY and OCB are 90 degrees.
One minute. First, what is the question they're asking? Try to understand the question first. Yeah. X, Y and X dash Y dash. So this line and this line are parallel tangents to a circle. X with center O and another tangent AB with point of contact C. This is the point of contact C. This is another tangent. Intersecting XY at A and YB at B. To prove that AOB is equal to 90 degree. You have to prove that AOB. When this angle is equal to 90 degree, we have to prove. Now tell Samar, now how to prove this.
And so there is another 90 degree up there. You see that.
You are talking about that pilot. This yeah. one, right? And this is also perpendicular. Next.
Below. And angle A, OCY, you see, that's 90 degrees.
OCY?
Yeah.
Where is C? Okay, OCY is 90 degree. Okay, fine.
Yeah. So, next. Here, PY, that PA, right? That's A point.
Okay, yeah. PA.
Is equal to AC.
Yeah, this side is equal to this side because these are perpendicular tangents. Yeah. Sorry, tangents are equal from any single point. Tangents are equal, right?
Yeah.
So these two tangents are equal. Again, you can say these two tangents are also equal, down one, right?
Yeah.
Next, what to do?
Here, sir, from there we can know that that POC plus PAC, we will get 180 degrees.
POC and P. POC and which one?
PAC.
And PAC.
Yeah.
Is equal to 180 degree.
Yeah.
POC is fine. POC is 90 degree on what base?
Sir?
POC is 90 degree on what base?
We didn't say it as 90 degrees. They are forms at a tangent and we know that they are equal. So from there only we can say.
Okay. So you mean to say this? Yeah, that's fine. See what is Samarth is saying that. Again, you just try to understand here. Which one we are talking about? See this one. Only we are talking about this one. What I'm just seeing, red graph you see here. This part only we're discussing right now. So in this is quadrilateral. This already is 90 degrees given. It means that other two angles, this angle and this angle is equal to what? Complete angle is equal to 180 only. Understood what I'm saying? See angle, what we write here, POC plus angle PAC is equal to what? 90 degree, 180 degree. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes.
Okay, next tell you so much, next part.
Yeah, from the below tangents also we'll get that is 180 degrees, the sum of it.
So here again we get 80 degree. This is 90 and this is also 90, this side. So this and this is 180 degree you are saying, right?
Yeah.
So what you can write, angle QOC plus angle CQB is equal to 180 degree. After this, what you will do? Angle QOC plus angle QBC is equal to 180 degree. Next, what we can do, Samar? Tell me. I can't hear you.
Okay, so the mic was off. Yeah. The total angle will be 360 degrees, right?
Yeah.
Total angle will be 360 degrees. Then.
Then.
From those points, we got AP equals to AC.
AP is equals to AC.
Yeah, those tangents, right?
That is there. That is equal only. Yeah, fine. That is there.
Yeah.
That
already and OP equals to OC as they are the radii.
OP is equal to OC. OP is equal to?
OC.
Huh, that is fine. Huh.
Yeah, equals to OQ.
Hmm.
You can see there.
OP is equal to OC is equal to OQ. Huh.
So we can prove them both triangle AOP and AOC as similar, right? Congruent.
These two, right?
Yeah. Huh. You can prove them congruent. They are. So, sir, angle PAO equals to CAO.
These both angles are equal.
Yeah.
Again, these both angles
in them are equal. So, sir, PAC, you see, the whole equals to 2PAO. We can write it like that.
2PAC is equal to 2PAO. How we can actually, we can write like that. So see here, PAO, this angle is equal to this angle. PAO is equals to what? CAO, this both angles are equal. If you approve, this is congruent. If you approve this congruent, then what we can write here? This angle is writing here with the black color now. Blue just let me write. This angle and this angle both are equal, right? And again, this angle is equals to this angle. We can write. So we can write here PAO, 2PAO you should write. 2PAO is equal to what? 2PA is equal to PAC, correct? 2 angle PA is equal to PAC. This one you are saying, yeah. Samar?
Yeah, next. Equals to CAO. Equals to 2CA.
Is equal to 2CAO.
Yeah, same only, right?
It's given, no. 2PAO is equal to PAC, right? That only, no.
Yeah, but equals to 2OAC, it will be there, right?
OAC.
That's another angle, another side of it. We can also do it.
OAC.
Yeah.
PAO. Yeah, we can write AOC also, fine.
Yeah. Similarly, in the other, that tangent one you see.
Again, we can write this one. Angle is equal to this angle. This angle is equal to this angle, correct?
Yeah.
Hmm.
So, we got the total as 180 degrees from the previous thing, as we had calculated.
Yes.
I was saying, right? So, we will get 180 degrees equals to 2 into OAC.
Wait, I just put here this only what you are saying, that same thing. I just copy and pasting here and discussing with, because people will not understand if we do like this, no?
Yeah.
All will not understand like this. So let me erase everything first. And we'll distract one by one, we'll discuss.
Because yeah, like this.
Okay. Yeah. So this is the part, no?
So
yes, sir, it's some sort of the same as I was saying. A little bit different from the last.
Yeah, same only, almost.
Yeah.
See, first by, we have to make this is congruent, okay? So see, triangle AOP and AOC. AOP, so many children has off the cameras. What happened? Rishi, Shreyas, Chanchal. Shreyas, you have done this question.
So now I'm trying, sir.
Okay. Praharshan?
Yes, sir.
Adarsh?
Sir.
So see, we are comparing these two triangles, AOP, this triangle you see, and AOC, these two triangles we are just comparing. So we by SSS rule, we got these both triangles are congruent. If two triangles are congruent, then what we have done before, we can write it as, if two, these two triangles are congruent, we can write it as this angle is equals to this angle. Again, you can write this angle is equals to this angle. Okay, we can write like this. Fine. So the same thing is mentioned over here. PAO is equals to CAO, this one. This angle is equal to this angle. Again, PAC, whole thing is equal to 2PO, and this you can write this on whole thing, right? Or PAC is equal to 2AOC, 2 times of OAC. OAC, you can see here, OAC, this angle is twice of complete angle PAC. Similarly, you can write for this also triangle QBC is equal to 2 QBC. These two things, 2 points you are understanding or not, ticking mark. These two are understanding it or not, is C. See, this one angle is equals to this one. So can you write here PAC, means whole angle, is equals to twice of 2 OAC. OAC is just half of it. Half of PAC is what? OAC. And similarly, we are using for this triangle also. QBC, this whole both part equal to this. So we can write QBC is equals to twice of OBC. Okay. So adding first and second. First and second, if you add, what do you get? OAC plus OBC is equal to what? 90 degree. OAC plus OBC is equals to what? 90 degree. Means OAC is nothing but OAC. This angle. And OBC. This angle. Both are equal to what? 90 degree. So now your triangle, you can see it, AOB. AOB triangle you see now. AOB triangle plus AOC. AOB plus AOC plus OBC is equal to 180 degree. Then OAOB you can find. Now only substituting here, okay? Only you are substituting here 90 degree. That AOB you should find, right? So angle AOB plus OAC is equals plus OBC is equal to 180 degree, and this both already we know, this both equal to what? 90 degree. And if this both equal to 90 degree, then what? AOB is equal to 90 degree only. So I'm writing the steps. If you're having doubt, ask. First, second, third, fourth, fifth. Which step you are having doubt, just ask. Twice we have to do both the times. Twice, both the times. Shreyas, you have done the same way or different way?
Same way, sir.
Rasul, you are getting this? Having down in any steps?
Yes, sir. Same way.
See, the proving sums, you have to think much actually in these things. What we have to prove, that is should concentrate on that part. AOB. Here we have to prove AOB, right? So AOB, how to bring AOB, that we have to think over here. Drishi, I think you are having doubt, right?
No, sir, understood.
So question number, which question is this? Question number 9th. Now question number 10th. Prove that angle between two tangents drawn from the external point. Question number 11. Just see over here. This is a question number 11. First, you try to understand the question. Prove that the angle between two tangents. Prove that angle between two tangents drawn from an external point to a circle is supplementary to the angle subtended by the line segment joining the points of contact at the center. You should prove 180 degree, right? To prove that angle between two tangents drawn from external point to a circle. Means if you are having a circle over here, from external point you are drawing tangent to the circle, is supplemented to the angle subtended at the line segment at the point of contact at the center. You mean to see this both angles, right? This angle and this angle are what? 180 degrees. This only you should prove, right, Samarth?
Yes.
So here we have to put supplementary means 180 degree. The between which angles? Angle subtended by the line segment joining the point and the point contact at the center. This both equal to 180 degree. We have to prove that. Okay. So this is the damn easy question. Nothing is there in this. We know already. See what to do here. We knew already this is equal to 90 degree. And this also is equal to 90 degree. So obviously other two angles are this only now in this quadrilateral, correct? So this is the very easy question. Nothing to do in this question only. Once again, you see here, we have to prove that these two angles are equal to what? 180 degree. And already we know that this angle and this angle is equal to what? 90 and 90, 180, right? So 180 happened means in the quadrilateral 360 degree will come. The other two angles will be what? 360 degree only, right? You are getting it, Adarsh, what I'm saying? Once again, I'm telling you, see here. This is a circle. From outside point, if you draw any tangent to the circle, so to prove that this angle and what is coming at the center, this angle, this both angles equal to what? 180 degree, okay? This both angles are equal to 180 degree. So how this will come 180 degree? If this is already 90 degree, this is also 90 degree. So 90 plus 90 is what? 90 plus 90 is 180. Got it? So obviously other two angles are what? 180 degree only. Is it clear, Adarsh?
Yes, sir.
Rasool, is clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Now see how to express in the terms now. How to explain the terms, try to understand this. PA and PB are two tangents. A and B are the points of contact of tangents. OA is perpendicular to AP and OB is perpendicular to BP. So OAP and OBP is equal to 90 degree. So the same thing is given over here, what we have discussed, right?
Sir, can we just prove it then do it?
Can we just prove it? What?
Prove that the both angles are equal and then do it.
Which both angles are equal here?
Sir, like draw a line PO, then prove that the both the triangles are equal, then do it.
Achha, that will prove. You can do if you want, but you are making longer simply. See, okay, this like, is a very, very easy question, not this one. What? Say.
So, like after the point where I can say angle R plus angle O plus angle P equals to 180, and how should I say that angle APB is also 90 degrees?
You can see anyway, no problem. But here you see, this OAPB is what? Quadrilateral? Yes. And this thing already you know, angle A and angle B is equal to 180 degrees. So if you remove 360 minus 180, you'll get 180 only. So this is very simple.
Okay.
So this is okay. So this is anyone having doubt in this? Next question number 12th was the toughest sum actually what we have done before. So this is the 12th one over. 13th one is also there in this 13th question.
Yes.
13th one.
13th one is third Chiron formula.
Which formula? 13th one?
Sorry. I'm saying Chiron's formula. That Pythagoras theorem.
Just okay. Let's see which formula is this. See, prove that opposite sides of a quadrilateral circumscribing a circle sustained supplementary angles at the center. Prove that opposite angles of a quadrilateral sustained supplementary angles at the center. Opposite side of a quadrilateral. So first you draw the question, how to draw this. Prove that opposite sides of a quadrilateral circumscribing a circle sustained supplementary angles at the center. So this is your circle. Why it's not coming? Try to draw the diagram first, all of you. How to draw the diagram is first you draw.
Sir, circumscribed is inside or outside?
Circum. 1 minute. The circle will be inside in the quadrilateral. Prove that opposite sides of a quadrilateral. Quadrilateral is like this, right? And circle will be somewhere like this. Okay. Opposite sides of quadrilateral circumscribing a circle sustain supplementary angles at the center. It means, you know, what is this? You have to match these two lines over here like this. So you have to prove that here is that this angle, okay. These are the opposite angles, this angle and this angles, both are what? Supplementary, you have to prove. And again, you can take this one angle is equal to this angle here is also supplementary. Okay, is it clear? So you have to prove in this way. This both angles are equal to 180 degree and this also both equal to 180 degree. You have to prove this one. How to prove? Chanchal, how to prove this?
Sir, we can take the PQRS as they are touching the sides of the circle.
PQRS?
Yes, sir. As the sides of the quadrilateral are touching to the sides of the circle.
Okay, fine. I'm just pasting the figure over here.
Hmm.
Sir, your voice is echoing from me. I don't know why.
Echoing?
Yeah.
Okay, now see, this is the angle. Okay, this is the question. And diagram is like this.
Sir, can I please rejoin?
Okay, okay, fine. You can rejoin. So this is the figure what you are having with you. So here you have to prove that AOB. AOB and plus DOC is equal to what? 180 degree, okay? AOB and DOC is equal to what? 180 degree. Again, DOA and BOC is equal to 180 degree. Like this you have to prove. Okay. Then all of you have off your cameras. Leave. So now we can prove. Just try now how to prove this. So from this figure easily you can write if you know.
So this is pretty easy, sir. I have done it already.
Yeah. This is a very easy. Angle A is equals to angle B. How angle B? Both are equal to angle B. OA bisect SOP. Wow. So angle A is equal to angle B, angle H is equal to angle G, angle C is equal to angle 2. Everything is bisecting here, right? And anyway, you
bisected. We proved that both are congruent. So that's why it is congruent.
And not required. Also, this property also is there, right? It's bisecting into two parts. If this, if you see this angle over here, why it's not working properly? So this first, second, third, fourth, you are having in doubt? First, second, third, fourth equations?
No, sir.
Now, AHED. AHED. If you add, you'll get 360. Twice we have done here. Because if you add all the angles, you'll get 360. Right? We are not writing B, D, F, and H. We are not writing. Because angle A is equal to angle B. Angle C is equal to angle D. Angle E is equal to angle F, angle G is equal to angle H. So only left hand part we are writing here and just multiplying with 2. Why you're multiplying with 2? Because same thing is repeating twice. Means angle B is equal to angle A, we can write now. The 2 angle A plus 2 angle C plus 2 angle this plus 2 angle this. Understood? We can write. So angle A plus H plus angle E plus angle D is equal to 180. And A plus H also you can write it as AOB. And E and D also you can write DOC. This is both equal to what? 180 degree. Okay. So any steps you are feeling difficulty over here? Only should have the tricks how to remember. How to do this. The supplementary at the center means which angle you should write. Is it clear what I'm saying? So half AHDE once you take. AHDE once you take. And once you take B, C, G, F, which angle you want, that you make double and write here 360 degree, all right. So whole exercise only got finished, 14th A, 14.1 and 4. So which one? 10th, no, 10.1, 10.2. So we'll do extra questions in the next class, okay? We'll do extra questions based on this. So please revise these things from your side, okay? So that will not have any doubts. So this question was question number 13th, I think. No? Yeah. Question number 13th.
Sir, extra questions, how many do you have?
How many you want? That much only I'll tell you. If you want 50, I'll give 50.
So, you have many, you think?
We can put, but circles will not only, very less questions will come from circles, not much will come.
Circus, yeah, it's a small chapter.
Small chapter only. You can so search.
We can donate 30 or 40 questions, that many only would be sufficient.
20 is sufficient, more than enough. All are similar type question now.
Yeah.
Okay, children, love, we can leave now. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Bye. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Bye.